Imagine a cosmic object so powerful that it could wipe your memory from 50,000 miles away. Not with fire, not with radiation, but with pure magnetic force so intense it would unravel the electrical signals in your brain. This isn't science fiction. These objects exist, spinning silently in the depths of space, and they're called magnetars. In the vast darkness between stars, where silence reigns supreme, some celestial bodies scream louder than all the rest. Magnetars are the universe's most extreme magnets, cosmic monsters that push the very laws of physics to their breaking point. Their magnetic fields are so absurdly powerful that they challenge everything we thought we knew about matter, energy, and the fabric of reality itself. Let's put this in perspective. Earth has a magnetic field that protects us from solar wind and allows compasses to work. It's strong enough to deflect charged particles and create beautiful auroras near the poles. Now multiply that strength by 1 quadrillion. That's a 1 followed by 15 zeros. That's the magnetic field of a magnetar. The comparison is so extreme it almost becomes meaningless, like comparing a whisper to a thunderclap heard across continents. If a magnetar somehow replaced our moon, hovering just 240,000 miles above Earth, the consequences would be immediate and catastrophic. Every credit card on the planet would be instantly erased. Every hard drive would be wiped clean. But the horror wouldn't stop with our technology. The magnetic field would be strong enough to disrupt the delicate electrical impulses that flow through your nervous system. Your thoughts, your memories, your very consciousness depends on tiny electrical signals jumping between neurons. A magnetar would turn that intricate symphony into chaotic static, then silence. But how does something so extreme come into existence? The birth of a magnetar is one of the universe's most violent spectacles. It begins with a massive star, at least 10 to 25 times more massive than our sun. For millions of years, this stellar giant fuses hydrogen into helium, helium into carbon, carbon into heavier elements, building up layers like a cosmic onion. But fusion has limits. When the core begins fusing iron, the star's fate is sealed. Iron fusion consumes more energy than it produces, and suddenly the star has no way to support its own crushing weight. What happens next occurs in less than a second. The core collapses catastrophically, and electrons are forced into protons, creating neutrons. The outer layers rebound off this incomprehensibly dense core and explode outward as a supernova, briefly outshining entire galaxies. But the real story is what's left behind. The core, now composed almost entirely of neutrons, becomes a neutron star. And in rare cases, when conditions are just right, when the star was rotating rapidly and the collapse occurs in a specific way, something even more extreme is born. A magnetar. The density of a magnetar defies human comprehension. Take a teaspoon, the kind you use to stir your morning coffee. Now imagine filling it with magnetar material. That single teaspoon would weigh approximately 1 billion tons. That's heavier than Mount Everest. That's roughly the weight of 900 Empire State Buildings compressed into a volume smaller than a sugar cube. At this density, atoms as we know them cannot exist. Electrons are crushed into protons, and matter exists in a state that laboratories on Earth can barely simulate for microseconds. The entire magnetar, despite containing more mass than our sun, is only about 12 miles across. You could fit it inside a small city. Imagine compressing our sun, which is nearly 900,000 miles in diameter, down to the size of Manhattan. The density is so extreme that a single cubic centimeter contains more matter than all the humans who have ever lived combined. But the true madness of magnetars lies not in their density, but in their magnetic fury. These fields are strong enough to warp the quantum vacuum itself. They twist space-time in measurable ways. They can literally change the shape of atoms, stretching them into elongated needles. At close range, the magnetic forces would overcome the electromagnetic forces holding molecules together. Your body wouldn't be torn apart by tidal forces or vaporized by heat. It would simply cease to exist as organized matter, atoms ripped from their chemical bonds by pure magnetic power. When magnetars erupt, they release energy that makes our sun look feeble. During what astronomers call a starquake, the magnetar's crust, made of crystallized iron a billion times stronger than steel, suddenly cracks and shifts. The magnetic field lines snap and reconnect, releasing gamma rays and X-rays in a catastrophic flare. In a single tenth of a second, a magnetar can release more energy than our sun emits in 100,000 years. Let that sink in. 100 millennia of solar output, released in less time than it takes to blink. On December 27, 2004, humanity witnessed the power of magnetars firsthand. A magnetar designated SGR-1806-20, located 50,000 light-years away on the far side of our galaxy, erupted in the most powerful explosion ever recorded from beyond our solar system. The burst of gamma rays and X-rays slammed into Earth just 45 seconds after leaving the magnetar's surface, though the light had traveled for 50,000 years to reach us. The effects were immediate and startling. Satellites went temporarily blind, their sensors overwhelmed. The flare ionized Earth's upper atmosphere, affecting radio communications. Some spacecraft were forced into safe mode to protect their instruments. And remember, this was from an object 50,000 light years away, halfway across the Milky Way. If a similar flare had occurred from a magnetar just 10 light years away, the consequences for Earth's atmosphere and biosphere could have been severe. It's a sobering reminder that we live in a universe capable of casual violence on scales we're only beginning to appreciate. Scientists estimate there might be 30 million neutron stars in our galaxy, and perhaps 10% of those could be magnetars. We've only confirmed about 30 magnetars so far, partly because they're difficult to detect, and partly because their active phase might only last about 10,000 years before the magnetic field decays. In cosmic terms, that's an eye blink. We're catching them in their brief moment of fury. Magnetars are teaching us that the universe operates on extremes we're still struggling to understand. They're natural laboratories for physics that we cannot replicate on Earth. Some scientists believe that studying magnetars might help us understand quantum chromodynamics, the force that holds atomic nuclei together. Others think magnetars could help explain fast radio bursts, mysterious signals from deep space that last only milliseconds but release as much energy as the sun does in days. There's even speculation that the universe itself might be fundamentally magnetic in ways we haven't yet grasped. Perhaps magnetism isn't just one force among many, but a key to understanding how reality is woven together at its deepest levels. Magnetars, in their extreme nature, might be showing us something profound about the cosmos. So tonight, when you look up at the stars, remember that between those pinpoints of light, invisible and silent, cosmic hearts of steel are beating. Magnetars are out there, spinning dozens of times per second, their magnetic fields twisting space-time itself. They remind us that the universe is far stranger and more powerful than our daily experience suggests. What other cosmic enigmas are waiting in the darkness, ready to challenge everything we think we know? The universe keeps its secrets well, but every magnetar we discover brings us one step closer to understanding the magnificent, terrifying reality we inhabit.